Hi everyone, it's Chad. As a designer advocate, one of the questions that I often get from teams is how to approach updating and then testing their design system assets in Figma. One way that I've approached this in the past, and something that I've seen other teams do as well, is to use two separate libraries for this. One library is used as a sandbox for updates and progress, and another library is used to copy assets to and publish as the production library for teams to use. But what if we didn't have to consistently maintain separate library files and manually copy updates between them? With branching, we have a space to explore updates in our main library files while keeping the source of truth intact. And with swap library, we can quickly change what libraries are being used in a file. So let's take a look at how we can use these features together to iterate and test our components using just our main library files. The first thing we'll do is open our component library. And let's say that we have a task to update the corner radius on some of our components. We're going to create a branch so we can make these updates without impacting what's currently published. Now that I'm in my branch, I'm going to go ahead and select all of our button variants, and we'll make them a bit more rectangular. And we'll also update our dropdown, and we'll update the inputs while we're at it. Now that I've made these updates and I'd like to test them, I would go up here, but I can't publish a library from a branch. What I can do is duplicate this branch as a new file and then publish that new file to test out the updates. I'm going to open my duplicated branch now as a new file, and the first thing I'll do is rename this, so we know that it is a test library. I'm going to go ahead and publish these components. And then I'll want to test these out in some files so I can see what these library updates will do to the files. So I'll go into some app screens that I've been working on. And we can see here, I have that button, the dropdown, the input, and we're going to use swap library to bring in our test library and see what those updates look like. If I go to my assets tab and then bring up the team libraries, here I can select the app components and then swap library to choose that test library we've just published. I'm going to uncheck the option to swap default styles in instances, so that way we're only swapping out these top level components. Once I hit swap library, I can see the updates and everything looks good here. So maybe I'm going to go back and merge my branch in and publish that update for everyone. But first, I'm going to undo that swap, and then I'm going to go back into the test library and unpublish this, since we'll no longer need the test library. Going back into the libraries window, I can go into the test library and unpublish this. And since we're done testing, we can actually remove this file. Now we're ready to go ahead back into our branch. We can merge this and then publish the updates from our main library for everyone to get. I hope that this will help you out in updating your components using branching and give you a little tip for testing through swap library. Thanks, I'll see you next time.